for all, safe at home, stay safe, right? But do not stop learning, keep learning, right? Here, in the previous session, I was dealing with the Vedic mathematics, right? The introductory part, the history of the Vedic mathematics and the importance of Vedic mathematics, and also the additions part. And those who have not watched the previous video of the Vedic mathematics, just click on the I button. You will be getting those video, right? In the session, I'm going to discuss the spark subtractions, which is the next technique in the Vedic mathematics. Now, spark subtractions are nothing but the vyavakalanam in Sanskrit. Right, let's get started with the subtractions. Now, before getting the techniques, the new techniques, we will learn the concept or the terminology. Right, the terminology here for the subtractions is that match combination here, match combination. Now, what is this match combination? Match combination is that combination when we subtract two numbers, okay? When I take two numbers, like here, if I take 8 and 5, I want to subtract 8 and 5. So, now, practically this subtraction is possible. Like if I'm having 8 pens with me, so I want to give 5 pens out of the 8 pens to my friend. So is it possible? Yes, practically the subtraction is possible, right? So such case is called as a match combination, okay? Match combination. That means where the subtraction is practically possible. So we know that 8 minus 5 is 3, right? Now here, what is the other terminology? Is that it is mismatch combination. Mismatch combination. Now, to the contrary here. To the contrary to this match combination, mismatch is that we can guess it that here. If I take the same numbers where I write 5 above and 8 below. So this is the mismatch combination. Why I am telling this as mismatch combination? Why we are keeping it as in that of mismatch combination? Okay, mismatch combination. Why? Because practically this subtraction is not possible. Right, 5 minus 8, you may tell, well, it is minus 3. But I am telling in the practical sense, I am having 5 pens. I am possessing 5 pens, but I need to give to my friend 8 pens. Is it possible? No. So, likewise, this combination is not possible practically. So, we consider like this subtractions as mismatch combination. Okay. And as well as like if I take, the first one, if you are taking 7 and 5, okay. 7 minus 5. This is 2. Okay. Now, we will understand the terms also before going into the subtractions. Now, 7 minus 5 is 2. This is clearly a match combination. Now, here, the first one from which we are subtracting is called as minuend. Minuend. Right? The first one with which, like from which we are going to subtract, is called as the minuend. Whereas the second one with which we are going to subtract is called as the subtrahend. This is called as the subtrahend. This is the terminology, right? Now, you know the answer. The answer is nothing but the difference. Now, wherein you get additions, the answer, the solution is called as sum. In multiplication, the answer is called as the product. Likewise, Here the answer which we get for a match combination, this is the difference, right? This is the simple terminologies. Now here, when the minuend is greater than, when comparatively, compared to the subtrahend, minuend is greater, then it is called as a match combination. Whereas when the minuend is smaller compared to the subtrahend, then it is called as a mismatch combination, right? Another terminology is that complement. Now, we also know in our conventional mathematics, complementary angles. Now, the complementary angles, a pair of angles which sum up to 90 degrees, 30 degrees, 60 degrees, they form a pair of complementary angles. Likewise, the complement here is, now, I want the complement of 1. The number 1. The complement of 1 is 9, I say. That means, when I add this number, I have to get 10. A total of, a sum of 10. That means, the complement of 1 is 9. Whereas, vice versa. Like, the complement of 9 is 1. Right? Likewise, the complement of 2 is again 8, right? That means the sum, so 2 when added to 8 only you get 10. So the complement of 2 is 8, whereas the complement of 8 is 2 again. Now likewise for 3 we can say it as 7, for 7 it is 3. Now like 4, the complement is 6, for 6 the complement is 4. Same way for 5, the complement is 5. Whereas for 5 again, the complement is 5. So this is the concept of complement. Now, this is match combination wherein the minuend is greater than the subtrahend, and mismatch combination wherein the minuend is smaller than the subtrahend. So this is the terminology. Now we will start the subtractions, right? Now, a single digit, we got it. Now we'll start with a double digit, okay? Double digit with a single digit. Subtractions, right? Here, double and single. No, I won't write plus here because double and single. What we are doing? We are not doing addition. We are doing subtraction, isn't it? So, let me take 3 and 8. And I want to subtract here from 6, okay? Right. This one, a double digit with a single digit. Now, here in Vedic mathematics, we were telling that we have to proceed from left to right. Always from left to right. Right? So, the subtractions also we do from left to right, not from right to left. Okay. Now, here, I will, what is there below 3? Any digit is there? No. So, I'll simply drop 3 as it is. Okay. Now, see the next pair here, 8 and 6. So, 8 minus 6 is 2. Okay. What I did, the simple subtractions, what you do in the convention method, but you do from right to left. But here, you can observe that when I'm dropping 3 here, I will be checking the next combination. The next combination here is the minuend is greater than the subtrahend. That means it is a match combination. Okay. This is a match combination. If it is a match combination, I do subtractions as it is. Okay. Now, to the contrary, let me take another example. 38. Okay. Now, let me take 9 here, okay, 38 minus 9. Now, I'll do the subtraction here. Now I'll below 3, there is no digit here, so I'll be dropping 3 as it is, okay. And before dropping 3, I'll check the next pair here, next combination, is it mismatch or match, like. Let us see here, from 8, 9, that is practically not possible. So that is called as, or else we can also say the minuend is smaller than the subtrahend. That means this is clearly a mismatch combination. Okay, This is mismatch combination. When you get a mismatch combination, the next number, you have to reduce this number by 1. Okay, you have to reduce this by 1, 1 digit. That means 3 becomes 2. It is reduced to 1. Next, what you have to do, since this is mismatch combination, practically what I told directly, we cannot subtract, isn't it? So what you have to do, you should not subtract, but instead we should take the complement of the below number. The complement of below number is 1. This is added to 8, okay? Complement of 9 is 1, isn't it? The complement of 9 is 1. So this 1 is to be added to the above number. So it becomes 9. 8 plus 1, 9. So it is 29. Here, I am explaining you again here. 29. How we got this 29? This is mismatch combination. So when it is mismatch combination, that means our minuend is smaller than the subtrahend. That means practically subtraction is not possible. So we should not subtract. What we have to do, the before digit we have to reduce it by 1. That means the 3 will be reduced to 2. And for this combination, since it is mismatch, I will be adding the below number complement to the above number. 8 plus 1 is 9. Simply I'll write it down. So let me explain you using this. Now I'm reducing 1. 1 I'm reducing. So what we have learnt in the additions, ekadhikena purvena, we are adding 1. If it is a carry combination. Now here we are reducing 1 when it is a mismatch combination. So this is a sutra in the Ekanyunena Purvena. Okay, this is a sutra in the Vedic maths when Eka means 1, Nyunena means reducing, Purvena, the before number. So I am doing this sub sutra here because this is a mismatch combination. I am reducing the before term by 1. So that sutra we are using here. Now quickly pause the video and note it down. Let's see few more problems. Now let me take another example here. 46. Okay, subtracted from 8. Let me a double digit subtracted from a single digit right here. Now we will start from left. Okay, I'll drop from 4. There is nothing here below digit. So I'll drop 4 as it is, 4. But before dropping the 4, we have to check the next one. This is match or mismatch? Here clearly this is mismatch, right? Because the minuend is smaller, isn't it? And also you can also see that practically subtraction is not possible. So that is mismatch. When it is a mismatch combination, you have to reduce the before number by 1 digit. So 4 before dropping, I'll check this. If it is mismatch, I will reduce 4 by 1. That becomes 3. Right. Now what I have to do? Here I'm telling practically, directly, the subtraction is not possible. So I shouldn't do subtraction. I have to go for the addition only. Now what is the complement of 8? 8 is 2. Complement is 2. So this 2 should be added here. So it becomes 8. 6 plus complement of 8 is, complement of 8 is 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. So simply do, you have to do. So the answer is 38. So for illustration, I've told like that, but we have to do everything. The complement you have to think over in the mind and add it to the above number. When it is a mismatch combination. When it is a match combination, no problem. You have to go with the original subtractions. Now here, let me take another number. Let us take 74 subtracted from 8. Okay, let us take this. Now, before dropping 7, I'll check whether this is mismatch or match. Now, this is clearly mismatch. So, mismatch means I have to reduce this. So, this becomes 6. Now, I shouldn't do subtraction, but the complement of 8, complement of the below number should be added to the above number. So 4 plus 2, like this 4 plus 2 comes to 6. Okay. So complement of 8 is 2. 2 should be added here. So I'm not doing subtraction, but I'm doing indirectly I'm doing the addition only for the mismatch combinations. Now here let us take 89 and 8. Okay, subtraction. Now here, before dropping 8, I'll see whether this is match or mismatch. Clearly it is match because subtraction is possible. Here the minuend is greater. So I will drop as it is 8. I'm not reducing 8 because this is match combination. When it is match combination, subtraction is possible. So I will do the subtraction as it is. Okay, 9 minus 8. If it is not possible practically, then only I'll go and add the complement of below number to the above number. That's all. Now, if you take here 43 minus 3. Now here, likewise. Now, I'll drop the 4 as it is here. This is match or mismatch? I don't know because the two numbers are there. So I cannot decide whether it's match or mismatch, right? Because here practically it is possible, isn't it? From 3, I have 3 apples. I will be giving 3 apples to my friend. Okay, that's possible. So this is 0. Okay, now here there will be a special case which we will discuss in a later in the session. Okay, so if there is same numbers in the end, no problem. If it comes in between, what is the special case, I will be discussing. Now let me see here for the double digit and a double digit. Let us take a double digit and a double digit, a combination of 2. Right, here 84 minus 29. Let me take this. Okay, now I'll start from left. Okay, 8 minus 2. Why am I doing minus here? Because it is a match combination, so I'm doing subtraction. So 8 minus 2 is 6. Before dropping 6, I'll check whether the next one is match or mismatch. Here it is clearly mismatch. When it is mismatch, you have to reduce by 1. Okay, so this 6 will be reduced by 1 and becomes 5. And what I should do, this is not possible. So the complement of 9 is 1. 1 should be added to 4. So it becomes 5. So clearly the answer is 5. Right. Now, likewise, let me take 78 subtracted from 69. Okay. So now let's start from left. 7 minus 6 is 1. Okay. 1. Before writing 1, I will see whether this is match or mismatch. This is mismatch. So I have to reduce 1. So 1, if I reduce by 1, it becomes 0. Okay, it becomes 0. Now here, this practically subtraction is not possible. This is mismatch. So I have to add this complement of 9 to the above 1. So complement of 9 is 1 to the above 1 is 9. Simply 0, 9. 9 is the answer. Right. Likewise, if you take 87 by 47. Okay. Now here, let's check. 8 minus 4, this is possible, match. So 8 minus 4 is 4. Before dropping 4, I'll check whether this is match or mismatch. Here this is match. This we cannot tell if it is match or mismatch. But let us see practically. From 7, I have 7 items. I'm giving away 7 items. So it is possible, isn't it? So 8 minus 4 comes to 4 and 0. Simply as it is, we are doing subtraction. Only case when we get a mismatch combination, we are reducing 1, the previous number, and we are adding the complement of below number to the above number. That's all. Now let me take a double digit and a triple digit. Okay, and a triple digit. Right. Okay, That means a triple and a double, I mean to say. Right? Here, let me take 386 subtracted from 90, suppose 99. Okay? Now, let's get started from the left. Right? I'll drop 3 as it is. But before dropping 3 here, I'll see this is mismatch. So, I have to reduce 3 by 1. So, it becomes 2. Now, what I have to do here? Here, I have to do the complement adding. 1 should be added to 8. So, this becomes 9. Before writing 9, let me see. This is mismatch. So, 9 mismatch. So, 9 becomes 8. Okay. Now, here again, complement I have to add here. So, this comes to 7. Right? Now, let us take another example. 465. Right. Now, this is 9 and this is 4. Okay. Let me subtract here. Now, let's start from the left. Okay. These are the complements, isn't it? Now, let's start from the left here. 4, I'll draw. Before dropping, see this is mismatch. This mismatch means I'll have to reduce. 4 should be reduced to 3. Now, here, complement I will add. So, 1 should be added to 6. That comes to 7. 7. But before dropping 7, see here. This is match or mismatch? It is clearly match. So, 7 is as it is 7. I'm not reducing. Right? So, 7. Now, here also we are not doing any complement because this is possible. Subtraction is possible. So, 1. Right? So, here a variation that these two are mismatch. Here, a mismatch and a match. So, for you to explain it, I have to. So, a triple digit minus double digit. Please note it down. Pause and note it down. Let's see a triple and a triple digit. Now, here we will see a triple digit and a triple digit subtractions. Now, here. Now, let me take 786 subtracted from 398. Okay. Randomly I'm taking, I'm not, these are not pre-planned, right? Some numbers are not given. So, on the own I'm taking randomly. Now, let's start from the left, okay? 7 minus 3, so I'm doing minus B and I'm writing 4. Before writing 4, let me check. This is mismatch, so 4 is reduced to 3. Now here, when it is mismatch, I have to add the complement. 9 complement is 1. 1 should be added to 8. So, comes to 9. Okay. But 9 will be again reduced to 8 because this is mismatch. Now again, complement of 8 is 2. 2 to add it here. So, it becomes 8. Now, for few steps to practice, you are writing the complements. Otherwise, no need of writing the complements. Now, in the second step, we will not write the complement, okay? Now, 4, 9, 4, 6, okay? 8, 8, 8, 9. Let us take 8, 8, 9. Right. Now, we will not keep any complement, anything. Just I will proceed. Okay? Let's start here. 9 minus 8, 1. But this is mismatch. 1 will be reduced to another 1. So, that becomes 0. Now, here complement of 8 is 2. 2 added to 4 comes to 6. But here mismatch, 6 becomes 5. Now, here 9 complement is 1. 1 added to 6 is 7. So, simply 57 is the answer. So, all this what I'm telling out should be done in the mind. Okay. Vedic mathematics is a method which is logical, which involves mind power. Okay. So, let me take another 8, 9, 6, right, 3, 4 and 8. A combination of mismatch and match I've taken. Now, here, 8 minus 3, 5. But the next number is match. So, 5 is 5 only. 9 minus 4 is match. So, I have to do subtraction. So, 5. But the next number is mismatch. 5 should be reduced 1. So, it comes to 4. Now, here, you have to add the complement. So, it comes to 6 plus 2. So, no need of writing. You have to write mismatch. So when it is mismatched, you need to add the complement of the below number to the above number. That's all. 584. Now this is triple digit by triple digit. Please note it down. And also we will do any digit to any digit, right? Any digit number. Let me take in random any digit number. Let us take here 3. Okay, right? Any digit to any digit. Now let me take this as 3, 9, 4, 9, 8. Okay, this comes to 7. Let me take this number. So this is 6 digit. Any digit to any digit. Now we'll start. 4 minus 3, this is possible. So I'm doing subtraction. 4 minus 3 is 1. Before dropping 1, let me check this as match or mismatch. Here it is mismatch. So 1 is reduced again. So this becomes 0. Now here mismatch. So I have to add the complement. 9 complement is 1. 1 to be added to 8. So it comes to 9. But here it is match. So 9 is 9 only. Right here. Now this is match. So directly I'll write 5. 7 minus 4 is 5. But 5 next number is mismatch. So 5 is reduced to 4. Now here 1 complement is 1. 1 is added. So it comes to 7. So now it is not reduced because this is directly match. So 1. 9 minus 8 is 1. But this is mismatch. So 1 is reduced to 0. So this, the complement of 7 is 3. 3 is added to 3, comes to 6. So the answer is here 94706. Okay. That is the answer. This is a 6 digit number. We got a 5 digit number. Right. Likewise. So checking whether they are mismatch or match. If it is a mismatch combination, you reduce 1. If it is a match combination, as it is, subtract it. And if it is a mismatch combination, what do you do? You have to add the complement of the below number to the above number. That's it. Those two points you need to remember in this Spark subtractions. You can do any digit minus any digit subtractions. Now, and here there is a special case also. Now, when we go to, let me take this triple digit. 7, 8, 6. Okay. 7, 8, 6. Subtracted from 76, suppose. Okay. Why am I taking this? I want to tell you cases of the same digits. Okay. Same digits. If you are getting same digits, now they are in the end. I've got the same digit in the end. So you can do the same procedure. 7 will be dropped down, but this is match. So 7 is 7 only. 8 minus 7 is 1 only. 660. So as it is, all the subtractions I did as it is. Because 6 is possible. 6 items I'm having, I'm giving 6 items. So that is possible. So I'm doing the subtractions. So that means whenever the same digits are there in the end, this is as it is, you can do. But the special case is that when the same digits are in between, so that is an exceptional case in between the numbers. So we will discuss that special case. An exceptional case. We were also discussing in the additions, right? The special case when it sums up to 9. Okay, the special case is that, let me take now what I told the special case as the same digits, if they are placed not at the end or at the front but in between the numbers, if the same digit comes, that is a special case. So let me take here 8, 7, 6, 5, 9. Okay, so here let us take 2, 9 here. This again, let me take here some 4, because 6 and 6 we saw. So let me take 4 and 4 here, 9 here, 3. Okay. Some numbers, let us start. Now this is a special case because we are having the same digits in between, not at the end. If they are at the end, they are not considered as an exceptional case. Now, if they are in the middle, what we have to consider, we will proceed. Now, 8 minus 2, practically possible, so I'll write 6. But before writing or dropping 6, I'll check this is a mismatch. So, 6 will be reduced by 1, so it comes to 5. Now, I will add the complement. So, 9 complement is 1, 1 added to 7 is 8. Now, before dropping 8, should I reduce or should I write? That will be dependent on the next number. So, the next number is 4 and 4. Whether that is match or mismatch, again we have to check seeing the next number. Here, checking the next number, there is no number here. So, this is match only. But here, when you are getting same digits, you have to go for the next number. Next number, if it is mismatch combination here, this is mismatch. So, clearly this also becomes mismatch. If the next number is mismatch, the same digit will become mismatch. Now, if the next number is match, the same digits will become match. Okay, that is the exceptional case. If it is in between, the same digits are in between. So, I am considering this as mismatch here. Why? Because the next numbers are mismatch. You are considering mismatch. When you are considering mismatch, you have to reduce here, isn't it? Reduce one number. So, this 8 becomes 7. Right. Now, what I have to do for the mismatch numbers? I should not. When I am telling them as mismatch, I should not subtract. I have to go for the addition of the complement. Now, 4's complement is 6. 6 added to 4 is 10. Okay. 10, but the next number is mismatch, so 10 should be reduced by 1, so obviously you get 9. Now here again I should not subtract, but I have to add the complement. 9 complement is 1, 1 added to 5 is 6. So before dropping 6, I'll see this is match only, so 6 is 6 as it is, and I'm doing the subtraction here. Why am I doing subtraction here? This is a match. Okay. So, when it is possible, you can do the subtraction. When it is not possible, that means practically not possible. That means a mismatch combination. Mismatch, you go, you reduce one before term. And why am I telling this as an exceptional case? Because if you are getting in between the same digits, so it is an exceptional case. These digits are considered as mismatch depending on the next one. If the next one is match, it is also match. Let me give you another example and explain you the special case. Now we'll take match combination only. Now if it is the same number, 7, 8, 4, now here 5, 9, right? But the below number I'll change, 2, 9, 4, same digits here. But the next combination I'll write it as match, okay? So that you'll clearly understand. Now, the digits, this is exceptional case because the digits are same and they are placed in between. So, let us decide whether these are match or mismatch. It depends on the next number. This is match. Match combination. So, this also becomes match. So, again, let's start. 8 minus 2 is 6. But this is mismatch. 6 will be reduced 5. Now, the complement of 9 is 1. 1 plus 7 is 8. But 8 is reduced or not, let me see, this is mismatch or match. So this is mismatch, this is match, again this is match. So match means I should not reduce, I have to drop as it is and do the subtractions. 4, 4, 0, 5 minus 3, 2, 9 minus 3, 6. So nothing I did. When even the same numbers are there, when it is considered as match, so I have done simple subtraction. So this is an exceptional case. Let us take another example and I'll explain you clearly here. 8, 9, 4, 6, 3, 9, 8. Okay, this is a 7 digit, right? Now here 6, 3, 9. Okay, again 6, again 3, 4. Okay, let me take this as mismatch here. 8 and 9 here, and this is 4. Right. Now, if I explain this, you will clearly understand. Now, here, let's start from the left. 8 minus 6 is 2. Here match only, so 2 is as it is 2. 9 minus 3 is 6. Here mismatch, so 6 will be reduced to 5. Now mismatch means complement I have to add. 9 complement is 1. 1 is added to 4, 5. So this becomes 5. Okay. And here this is reduced or not. Let us see. This is mismatch or not. Mismatch or not. I don't know. I'll go for this. This is mismatch clearly. So this becomes mismatch. This becomes mismatch. All right. So if this is mismatch, I have to reduce 1. So this 5 becomes 4. Okay, now here what I'll do for the mismatch combinations, I have to add the complement. 6 complement is 4. 4 added to 6 is 10. 10, but the next is mismatch, so 10 is reduced, so it becomes 9. And here the complement is 7. 7 plus 3, 10. Again mismatch, 10 is reduced to 9. Now here, again complement. 9 complement is 1. 1 plus 8 is 9. 9 as it is because this is match. So it is 4. The answer is here 2, 5, 4, 9, 9, 9, 4. Okay. So what we have done? The same digits. Same digits. These are decided as mismatch or match depending on the next digit. So the next digit is mismatch. So all these becomes mismatch. And mismatch 1 is reduced and complements are added. So likewise we can do any digit to any digit subtractions by spark subtraction. So this method is very useful, and in practice it makes the subtractions a faster and a smarter way. Now in our next session we will be seeing the subtractions only, but the next concepts, very interesting concepts. Okay, with this I'll end the class. Thank you all.